Welcome back to Rudy's 1/6 World for episode 27 of our new figure showcase, where I'll be doing a quick review slash posing session with the newest addition of my collection. And I mentioned this figure in my Commander Burnham review, and thanks to super fast shipping, I managed to get him in just before the new year. And it's none other than Commander Saru from XO6's ongoing Star Trek Discovery line. Like I mentioned on the Burnham review, I kind of pushed Star Trek Discovery to the side for a little bit, and hadn't been too keen on watching it. Needless to say, that was kind of a mistake on my part, and I really ended up liking the show. It's different from the shows that have come before, and frankly, I found myself definitely enjoying it a lot. It does rely a little bit more heavily on the action, but there are so many interesting characters, and I feel like it doesn't detract at all from the shows that have come before, which is key. So, I love the work XO6 did on their Commander Burnham figure, and I have high expectations for Commander Saru. I do think he's the first non-human figure that XO6 released, which is another reason I really wanted him. On the show, he clearly towers over everyone, and he has a very distinctive visual appearance and walk. And of course, Saru is a great character, and seeing his evolution from almost timid prey to a much more confident individual was definitely a highlight of the first two seasons. And seeing him finally take the captain chair in season 3 was a nice journey for him. I will say I'm only a little into season 3, so I don't know what becomes of his character, but at least from what I've seen, he's been great. Although, as a quick aside, the fact that Emperor Georgiou ate his alternate version, it's kind of disturbing when you think of it. There's a lot of eating of other species in the show, to be honest. I mean, Captain Georgiou's body is apparently eaten by the Klingons. Sorry, that was just a strange thought that popped into my head. Anyway, let's look at the figure itself and start with the overall package that XO6 is providing here. And I think if you saw the review I did for Commander Burnham, a lot of the notes regarding the accessories are going to be identical since they do come with the exact same items. So quick overview, he does come with different weapons, a communicator, tricorder, and a few interchangeable hands, and a utility belt that can hold all of the holsters for the equipment, as well as the standard XO6 transporter display stand. So I would say it's a more loaded release from XO6. Now, since I literally just looked at these accessories with Burnham, I'm going to breeze through them a little more quickly. And let's start with the phaser rifle. And this was something that XO6 made sure to showcase on social media with all the parts that it took to create. Unlike some of the other types of rifles we've gotten from them, these weren't a single molded element. Instead, you can see that they created the inner workings of the rifle and added full layers. So it does feel much more high-end, even with really amazing paint apps on the surface of the rifle and on the golds and all the parts of it. Almost like 6-scale military figures, which is a big compliment to XO6. The same can be said for the phaser pistol itself. It just looks like it's high quality. Not to take away from some of the other accessories that have come with other figures from the other eras, but I think for Discovery, the weapons are a little more complex, leaning more heavily into the modern weaponry we have today with rail systems and foregrips and so on. And here it also has pieces that detach, including a part that becomes a hand phaser, as well as a charging pack for the pistol. So great detail work. Next, we'll look at both the tricorder and the communicator. And just like the other accessories, these are all top notch with great detail work and color apps. They just look really good. And if you flip the tricorder around, you can actually put the sensor on it. So lots of nice minute detail work here. And the same with the communicator with the nice detail on the surface underneath the gold flip up cover. So I think you're seeing the trend here, which is the accessories on these releases are really something special. Next accessory is the utility belt, which is a rubber material, not pleather. So should be good for the lifespan of the piece. And it accommodates the holster for the phaser pistol, the pack for the tricorder, and for the communicator. And there's some nice detail work with the belt buckle and Starfleet insignia on the phaser holster, but not much beyond that. Definitely very functional, and I think this piece does accomplish that. Finally, he has a few extra hands, and this is where you can see XO6 shining as well. These are really good. From the paint application and choice that they made down to the detail work on the front of the hand and the nails and the texturing, they really did capture Saru's features really well here, so big plus. And without a doubt, that brings us to one of the critical parts of this figure, and that is the sculpt. And needless to say, this is impressive. This is, to me, without a doubt, I think one of the, if not the best sculpts we've gotten from XO6 so far. I mean, with the human character sculpts, they can be hit or miss, but this one is a straight up miniaturization of Saru from the show. The detail on this is amazing, even on the sides of the portrait where you can see all the detail work where his ganglia would come out from. The paintwork on this is incredible as well, including some nice pattern work replicating Saru's skin, and it all culminates in the bright blue eyes. So I am impressed with this. Head sculpt, I think, can compete with some of the big guys in the market, in the industry, if I'm being completely honest. I'm really impressed, and I think even for XO6 Star Trek collectors, this figure might be flying a little under the radar. So now let's jump to the uniform, which is pretty much a very similar version to the one we saw with Michael Burnham. Biggest difference aside from the size is the gold command color for the uniform. And again, a lot to like here with the amazing tailoring and stitch work, and also with a nice replica of the badge, including the three pips noting the rank of commander. Beyond that, the highlights are 100% the Starfleet insignia along the side of the uniform, replicated in that extremely miniaturized format, and the great panel work on the uniform shoulders, the elbows, and the knees, giving you a nice contrast instead of having this just being one solid jumpsuit. The one note, just like with Burnham, zippers on the pocket are actually just screen printed, and instead of being actual zippers, they still look good. So I'm not going to completely hold it against XO6, but if they had done actual zippers, it definitely would have been a highlight. Other piece that really stands out here, the boots. They have the nice gold soles to match the rest of the uniform, but the boots themselves are unique to accommodate Saru's foot, which is very different. And these look amazing. The detail work is great with the gold Starfleet Delta buckles, and again, I do really like how the figure is still able to stand on his feet without needing to stand. I will say you do have to play with him a little bit more, just to position the feet right in order to balance him. It can be done, you just need to be patient. Beyond that, as we look at some more poses with the figure, this is easily one of the more solid pieces as well, especially when compared to Burnham, and I'm going to focus on the wrist pegs. I told you about my incident with the peg and how it just sheared off for Burnham. For Saru, the pegs are definitely a little more robust, so I'm still being careful, but I don't expect to have that issue here at all. And then, just like with the other figures from XO6, the figures are highly poseable, so you can get some nice looks with Saru. I have to be honest, I don't really see any negatives here. The more I look at this figure, the more I think this is the best of the releases I've personally picked up from XO6, and I'm really hard-pressed to find any negatives here. If anything, the only thing I might have liked would have been the inclusion of the away team uniform that goes along with the utility belts. In one of the Season 1 mid-season episodes, where Burnham, Tyler, and Saru are on an away mission, Saru has a backpack on with a tactical vest. It would have been nice to have that, but that's the only additional accessory I might have liked. And look, XO6 is a much smaller operation, so I know that they're already giving us a lot here. So that's not a negative, them not including that part of the uniform. More just an accessory on a possible wish list. And I do like the way he looks posed next to Burnham. The two have been a pair that's continued to evolve throughout the series, so it's nice to have both of them here. If you saw my Burnham review, then apologies in advance if this is retreading some other territory, but I do think both of these would look great with a Captain Georgiou or a Captain Lorca. I know that last one is wishful thinking, but XO6 did tease a sculpt for him a while ago, so fingers crossed. He is on a list to be made at some point. I will also say, and I know this is a Saru video, but it might be nice to have some additional Mirror Universe versions of the characters. They already did Mirror Universe original series Spock and Sulu, so why not a Mirror Universe of Burnham? But that's hopes for the continuation of the line. Looking back at Saru, I have to say it one more time. I'm blown away by what XO6 was able to deliver here. And I'm going to say something, and hopefully my fellow Trek fans won't yell at me too much for this, but I think he dethrones Captain Benjamin Sisko as my top XO6 release of the year. I know, but I have to look at this as a figure, right? This isn't a reflection on my preference for characters or for shows, because we had 7 great seasons with Captain Sisko, and he was the emissary. I mean, he was a critical player in some of the major events impacting the Federation. So from a character perspective, Saru doesn't have that weight to him yet. But as a figure, I think they're both great releases, but I think Saru just edges out Sisko a little bit. And look, I love both figures. If you saw my Sisko review, you know that I was blown away by that release as well. So if anything, I'll say this. What a great time to be a Star Trek fan. I know XO6 gets a lot of heat on some of their releases, but if they can continue to release figures that are this good, we're in for a great 2023. And there's a lot of value here. The cost for this Saru figure was about $100 less than some Hot Toys figures, Damn Toys, and way less than in-art releases. And I think for what we got with this release, you're getting a lot of value. And I think that's where I'll close on Saru, because there's not much more to say except don't sleep on XO6. I think a lot of Star Trek fans are going to realize what's being produced here and might regret missing out on these figures. Case in point, look at what's happening on the secondary market with the recently released Star Trek The Motion Picture figures. They're blowing up, and similarly, the Picard and Data from First Contact, they're going way over original cost. So I know for me personally, I'm going to be very attentive to XO6's releases going forward, as I don't want to miss out on key characters. So that was a quick review of Commander Saru from the Star Trek Discovery show. Let me know your thoughts on this figure, and as always, thank you for watching. And if you are enjoying these reviews and some of my Breaking News First Thoughts videos, please go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll touch base on the next video.